Yeah, brothers and sisters, this is your absolutely favorite brother from another mother coming to you from the awkwardly mediocre state of North Carolina. I hope you guys are doing all right. I wanted to ask your help. I need to make a video. I need to ask you to pray with me for this anointing oil, brothers and sisters. I need to make a new batch of the anointing oil. The Lord had told me to make. Those of you watching my videos, I started making it there, I guess, probably November 2014. As the Lord had, this is only 2015. But anyway, last November, anyway, I started making it, I think it was, as the Lord had commanded me, and I need to make some more. And I've had this bottles of oil since then. There's a sister down there that gave me a whole bunch of bottles, and thank the Lord for that, of these small plastic bottles. It's awesome, you know. I've been having these in the room with me when I prayed, but these particular bottles I don't think I've laid hands on and prayed for specifically. I got two bottles here, and I asked you guys to come in agreement. Let's pray for this healing anointing oil, okay, brothers and sisters? You know, just like in the Bible, I'll just repeat it quickly, that, you know, Paul, they had handkerchiefs that Paul prayed over the handkerchiefs, and they took them out and touched people, and they were healed. And it's just a point of faith. As I made the videos in the past, it's only a point of faith, you know, but especially with the YouTube, Lord, with the internet, the Lord is everywhere. And so, you know, there's lots of people that I can't see, or they can't get to a church. They're not anywhere where they can go to a, you know, a spirit-filled church where they can pray for them to be healed. So we, the people that are my regular viewers, brothers and sisters, those of you guys, you know, we really are a church where two or more gathered in my name. There I am in the midst of thee, Jesus said. So we come as agreement as touching this oil, that what we agree to will be bound on earth and bound in heaven, and what we loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. So brothers and sisters, we come in agreement with this anointing oil as a point of contact, that we prayed over this, and as if we all went and laid hands on somebody, whoever uses this oil for healing, for baptism, Holy Spirit, all those things that I've been doing. And you know, I've sent out hundreds of bottles of it, and I don't know exactly how many. I would say about 250 bottles maybe. And anyway, there's been tons and tons of praise reports of people that were healed, baptized in the Holy Spirit, and all kinds of stuff. You know, even deliverance from demons and stuff using the anointing oil. And when I went places, I gave people bottles at all the places I went. I just carried them with me and stuff. But anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, the Lord told me to do this. So this is a ministry. This in itself is a ministry, but the people that I can't see and whatnot. I've also, the proceeds from that is for the Joshua's ministry, for the orphanages and stuff. So anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, and I'll say this again, there are people that God has designated to donate to Joshua's ministry to help me do the orphanages and the feeding programs, and even people that donate for my travels. It has nothing to do with any oil or the book that I wrote. You know, brothers and sisters, the Lord gave me that book to write, our final boarding call, Satan's plan for the ages, and our last mission. I wrote those things, and there's people who are, who most people, brothers and sisters, not most people, the most people who are, you know, attacking ministries, you know, Perry Stone or whomever they are, you know, they have some products, whether they be good or not, whatever, the Lord knows. You know, they have Bibles they sell. Even Dr. Jack Manimpi has DVDs that he sells of to support the ministry, to pay for his TV time and all that. You know, about who might be the Antichrist, all that kind of stuff. All ministries do stuff like that. And it's for the purpose of supporting the ministry. That's what God said, that even elders who teach are worth double honor, you know. So, God said, you know, don't muzzle the oxen that treadeth out the corn. And Paul said he's not talking about oxen. You know, I think that's 1 Corinthians chapter 9, maybe, or 2 Corinthians chapter 9. Forgive me, I can't think of where the text is right now. But, you know, the church supports God, the ministers of the gospel. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm just mentioning that. But I didn't do the oil for that purpose. But there are costs, shipping it out and all that. I just want to say that. And then, of course, the proceeds for the orphanage. Because people are already donating. Because God led them to donate. It doesn't do with any oil. Getting the oil is a gift that the Lord is using me to provide this gift to people, this anointing oil, point of contact they can use to pray for themselves, for the anointing that's on this ministry, and all the people that pray, all of you guys who will pray. There's lots of spirit-filled Christians, hundreds of spirit-filled Christians who will watch this video, who pray over this oil. And that anointing, you know, we're coming in agreement, you know. As the Bible says, if one can put 1,000 to flight, two can put 10,000. So the same things with the book. The proceeds from the book that the Lord gave me to write goes to the for the orphanages and the feeding programs and all that stuff that we do. And but I didn't write it for that purpose. It's just a side effect of it to do more orphanages and more feeding programs and all that. The purpose of it is this is a ministry. The book is a message to the church. And the anointing oil is a blessing to those who would use it for the glory of God. And it's a point of contact of faith, just like those who go to healing crusades. You know, like, what's his name? Not Billy Bright. It's down there in Florida. It's really, I actually went to a crusade and was an assistant to him before down in Florida. And he goes up to Philadelphia, too. I think his name is Billy Bright. Am I saying it right? Anyway, and God, you know, people, they believe, hey, if this brother's got a healing gift, praise for me, I'll be healed. You know, that's how it works. So this is the same thing as if I came there and prayed with you. Are the people who also are going to pray in agreement with me that have the gift of healing, that brother Brian Matuzak, OT4 Jesus, God uses him in healing. Other people. There's a brother there in Adelaide, Australia, Brother Terry, who's just getting started with a mighty healing ministry. He's going to pray in agreement over this too. You know, and who knows who else? Lots of people who God uses in healing. I shouldn't even start mentioning names. Sorry if I didn't mention your name. Other people, lots of other people. So praise God. So, brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray with me over this oil. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, Lord, hallelujah. We come in agreement, Lord, and we release your blessings and your anointing on this oil, Lord God. Lord, we speak that whomever this oil is applied to, Lord God, would receive the anointed prayer of all the people that come in agreement and pray over this oil. Myself and all those other people. All of the brothers and sisters in Christ, Lord, even as your word said, one can put 1,000 to flight, two can put 10,000 to flight. So how much can we, how much evil, how much darkness, how much sickness and disease can all of the hundreds of people pray over this, put to flight, Lord, away from the person who uses it, Father. So Father, we just come in agreement right now in the name of Jesus. Whoever uses this oil will be healed, will be set free, to be baptized, will be baptized in the Holy Spirit. We'll be delivered from the forces of darkness in Jesus' name, Lord God. Lord, we pray that this oil can be used to anoint the doorpost of anybody's house for salvation of the people who come in and out of that house through that doorpost, Lord God. Let anyone that enters the house through a doorpost where this anointing oil is used, that they would be convicted of their sins and become born again. They'd be delivered from the enemy. They'd be baptized in the Holy Spirit, Father. Father, we pray right now, Lord God, hallelujah, Lord, this oil be filled with all of our combined anointings from your Holy Spirit, Father, to deliver all who use this oil in Jesus' name. By faith in your name, Lord Jesus. Father, we pray in agreement right now, Lord God. Hallelujah. That whoever uses this oil will be blessed, Lord God. They'd be blessed going in and blessed coming out. Blessed in the city and blessed in the country. They would be the head and not the tail. Hallelujah. They would be blessed in all things, Father, of health, wealth, wisdom, peace, joy, and love in the name of Yeshua, HaMashiach, HaLelamas Subai, Alakuna Namasukeda Dabakuda Basubai, HaLamasukina Masubai. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you, we praise you, we praise you, Father. Hallelujah, Lord God, hallelujah. Thou anointest our head with oil. Hallelujah, Lord God, our cup runneth over. Hallelujah, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Hallelujah. Thus says the Lord. Hallelujah. That's a translation, interpretation I got of what I said, brothers and sisters. That's the end of the 23rd Psalm. Praise God. Praise God, for Jesus is the good shepherd. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. We thank thee, Father, creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father, for giving us Yeshua HaMashiach. For giving us the Ruach Elohim, hallelujah, the breath of God, hallelujah, the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Father, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord, for your divine mercies, your divine graces. We thank you, Lord God, for delivering us from the snare of the fowler, Lord God. We thank you for delivering us in times of trouble, in times of need, hallelujah, hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to come in agreement with me right now. The Lord is just telling me to pray that we'll just pray for Sister Linda Kirby right now, Lord God. And brothers and sisters, I ask you to come in agreement with me to pray for this sister. If you don't know who she is, just please pray in agreement with me. Because the Lord has never called out a name like that, I don't think, since I've been making videos for 4 years now. We decree and declare that the power of the enemy that's coming against her be broken in the name of Jesus. Come in agreement with me, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. That the snare of the fowler will not catch her in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. That she'll be lifted up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord says he'll lift you up, Linda, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 The Lord shall exalt and lift up the head of Linda Kirby. Hallelujah. That she'd go forward. She would go forward in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we give you the praise, Lord, that she's like the cupbearer of Pharaoh. She'd be restored. Hallelujah. In her ministry. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. We give you the praise. We give you the praise, God. We praise you, Yahweh, Most High God, El Elyon. Hallelujah. Creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For the Lord said, all things are lawful for me, but not all things are expedient. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah. I speak the expediency of thy will be done. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father. We praise you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. I thank you, Lord God, for all my brothers and sisters who's prayed in agreement with me. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to try to make some more videos, okay? We'll get this one out there. Thank you for praying in agreement with me over this oil. I got people that had ordered some, and I ran out. And praise God. I thank all of you guys for praying. You know, and I want to thank all you guys. While I was just earlier when I was talking to the Lord and praying, you know, the Lord said, he's not going to let us go, brothers and sisters. That's a word from the Lord to the bride, those who will be raptured, to the wise virgins. That's a thus says the Lord, I will never let you go. I'm not going to let you go. And that's, let me turn this down. The song is coming in my spirit right now. You know, I'm not a great singer, but it's called Mercy Said No. Mercy said no, I'm not going to never let you go. I don't remember. I haven't heard it in a long time. But the song is Mercy Said No, I'm not going to let you go. Maybe I'll come back with a video and I'll pray it next. I'll play it next time. God bless you guys. God bless you guys. Mercy said no. I'm not going to let you go. I'm not going to let you slip away. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Praise God. I love you guys. Love you guys. I'll see you in the air soon. Hallelujah. Now, brothers and sisters, I want to say again, these dreams I had can, you know, it's possible, you know, they could just be dreams. You know, I've said that before. I know you guys who are children of God, you understand these things. We see through a glass darkly. And in my own natural mind, I don't, and I'll say it again, I still don't believe the rapture is going to be now. In my own natural mind, you know, there's so many things to do. But in my spirit, the Lord keeps checking me that it's sooner than you think. It's even at hand, even at the door. That's what I'm hearing from the Lord. But you know what? The Lord at the door is not, can be years to us on earth. You know that? That's how the Lord is when he says immediately. It can be still not today, right? But, you know, that's what I'm hearing from the Lord right now. It's even at the door. It's even at the door, brothers and sisters. The return of the Mashiach is even at the door. Hallelujah. And the Lord says, I will deliver you. Yea, I shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to preach the good news. And the good news is that Yeshua HaMashiach came and he died. You came. You died. You rose again on high. You opened the way for the world to live again. Hallelujah for all you've done. Hallelujah. Praise his name, brothers and sisters. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. So we lift up holy hands in one accord, singing, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 I'm just seeing it, brothers and sisters. I'm seeing. Hallelujah. I'm seeing. Hallelujah. Across the eternity. I'm seeing across there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just over in the glory land. Hallelujah. Just over in the glory land. I just got a glimpse of it, brothers and sisters. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good. God is good all the time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're so unworthy, but for us he chose to die. He filled us with his Holy Spirit so we can stand and testify. God is good. God is good all the time. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. God is good all the time. That's all I know, brothers and sisters. You know, in my flesh, there's no good thing, as the Apostle Paul said. I'm only a man, like Peter said to Cornelius and his household. But by Christ, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, for he's able to deliver us to the uttermost. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Praise God. That same power that raised up Jesus shall raise you up in the end. The Bible says, hallelujah. Praise God. He's the deliverer. Hallelujah. Just like the children of Israel came out of Egypt by a mighty hand and a strong arm and spoiled the Egyptians. Hallelujah. So shall my church spoil this world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And come out by a mighty hand. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I just want to say this. I just wanted to put it out there and ask you guys, because I know you guys have, there's a wisdom in the multitude of counsel, to my dear, lovely brothers and sisters in the Lord. You know, I just feel from the Lord to be so trusting to everybody. So, you know, a lot of times, you know, I say what the Lord leads me to say, but I'm also cautious about trolls and all that. But the Lord has just given me this trusting spirit to you guys right now, to anybody, to the church. Praise God. God is really doing something. Thank him. Thank him. Bless his holy name. I asked you guys, the things that the Lord has been talking to me about and Brother Gary when we prayed, I got all these words from the Lord. And it's from the same text in the Bible. I didn't know it was from that text. I hadn't read that text in years. And then the things that we were praying and hearing were all from these two books in the Old Testament. I didn't know they were in those books. Exactly. So it's Nehemiah and Zechariah. And then just yesterday or two or three days ago, there's a sister who emailed me and said that, you know, the Lord had talked to her about those two books and specific passages and said that it's important that I look at them. And that's the same thing the Lord had been talking about. It's a sister, Nikki. And that's the same things that the Lord had been talking to me about and Brother Gary Bear, 049. So praise God, brothers and sisters. It's all about rebuilding the temple. It's all about the building up of Israel and Jerusalem, brothers and sisters, as we are at the end of the church age. Hallelujah. It's over. It's finished. And I said when I first started on YouTube, I used to quote, you know, when I was a kid, a teenager, we used to laugh at that because I guess I saw the movie. They used to show it all the time as a preview, that stupid Bill Paxton from Aliens, you know, the first day. He kept saying, game over, man, game over, dude. You know, that's really what it is, game over for the world. You know, game over is not really for the church. I mean, because we're going to be with Christ, the bride. You know, that those five wise virgins, you know, the church that is really awake and really born again and really walking with the Lord, truly saved and keeping the Lord's word patiently, we're going to be with Christ in heaven, raptured. But game is over for the dead church, the lukewarm church. The game is over for the lost and this world, and game over in this world, brothers and sisters. Then at the end of the 7 years, of course, game over for the false prophet and the Antichrist and Satan and all that, and for the devil's people. You know, right now it's game on. The tribulation is game on for the devil and his people. You know, it's game on for them for 7 years until the Lord returns to put an end to it, to rule this earth with a rod of iron. He will destroy the Antichrist, you know, with the word of his mouth and the brightness of his appearing and the word of his mouth. That's the end of the tribulation. You know, when it says every eye shall see him, and at the end of Matthew 24 and Revelation 1 where he talks about every eye will see him and all that, that's the second coming at the end of the tribulation. When the rapture, it says, you know, it's when he talks about him coming as a thief in the night. You can't come as a thief in the night and then every eye will see you and every tribe will mourn because of you and you're going to, you know, destroy them with the brightness of your appearing and the word of your mouth, you know, like he said in the beginning, let there be light. There was light. Jesus is the one. He's the word. God the Father plans. God the Son speaks. God the Holy Spirit executes. Read your Bible. You can see that in theology, like in Job. The Spirit of God put the crook in the snake and all those things. And the Holy Spirit was hovering on the face of the water, Genesis chapter 1. The Holy Spirit actually executes the word of God. And then we execute the word of God too, by the Spirit. And then angels execute the word of God by the Holy Spirit. But God the Son is the word. He's the one that speaks. So when God said, let there be light, that was Jesus. And so when the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah, when he returns, he's going to speak again. It says, by the word of his mouth, the sword of the Spirit coming out of his mouth. That's the word. He will destroy the Antichrist and to speak it. Just like he did in the beginning. Now, exactly what he'll say, I don't know. You know, be gone or whatever, however he's going to say it. You know, we don't know the words he will use. But he'll say it. It's done. Praise God. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Praise God. So anyway, brothers and sisters, I've been just flowing in the Spirit of God, brothers and sisters. Hey, God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good. God is good all the time. And I let you know, it's really true that we're so unworthy. But for us, he chose to die. Yes, he filled us with his Holy Spirit. That's why you need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. So we could stand and testify that God is good. God is good all the time. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. We are so unworthy. That's a whole other message, but I hope you know that. That's grace. That's salvation. The first step of the good news, and I've said this many times, I'll say it again, it's the Lord is leading me. The first step of good news is bad news. We're separated from God by our sin. We're lost and without hope in this world. Aliens and strangers to the covenants of God, the Bible says. Don't believe all these people saying, you know, even, you know, all these even famous preachers, oh, you know, even people that are, even the Pope said, you know, you can, atheists are going to heaven by their good works. We're lost and without hope in this world. Enemies and strangers of the covenants of God. Can you imagine that, brothers and sisters? We are enemies of God, even as Jesus said in John chapter 3. Those who do not believe on him, the wrath of God remains on them or abides, that King James word, the wrath of God abides on them. Hallelujah. Can you imagine? That's the bad news of the good news. Part one, you can't get the good news till you know that there's some bad news that needs to be answered with good news. The bad news is, without Christ, we're on the way to hell. Separated from God by our sin. That's the bad news. The good news is God made a way, one way, not many ways, not five ways, not 10 ways, one way. God could have made more than one way, but he didn't. He made one way. One way. There's a song in one way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. One way. That's Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah. He said, John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. Praise God. Praise God that God made a way. And that was through himself, as I've said many times in the past. As the Lord gave me that revelation years ago, when I made a video 2 or 3 years ago, when Abraham, Jesus said in John chapter 8, he said that Abraham saw my day and was glad in it. And they said, hey, you're not even 50 years old and you saw, you know, Abraham? And then Jesus declared himself to be God another time when he said, before Abraham was born, I am. See, that's like 2,200 years later, after the life of Abraham, here's Jesus saying, before Abraham was born, I am. You know, like he said, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. I am the way, the truth, and the life. All those times he said, declared, I am. This is, he said from the burning bush to Moses, I am that I am. Not I was, as in old dead religion, or not I'm going to be. But I am right now. God is I am right in this moment with us. God is with us. Hallelujah. Emmanuel. Anyway, brothers and sisters. So, Abraham, when he was about to take Isaac up the hill, you know, one of the greatest types, I've mentioned this before, I'm just repeating it if you haven't heard. When Abraham was taking his son, as a matter of fact, when God told him to sacrifice your son, and God even said your only son, Abraham, when they were going there, and it said after 3 days, Abraham saw the place where he was going to sacrifice Isaac. See, 3 days, Jesus was crucified for three and dead in the flesh for 3 days. So see, Abraham and all the types and shadows in the Old Testament, this is one of the best. Isaac was good as dead, as it says in the New Testament. In Jude, Isaac was as good as dead to Abraham. He was good as dead because God told him to kill him. Then they're traveling for 3 days. In Abraham's mind, he was good as dead. It was already done. He was going to do it. It says Jesus was dead for 3 days. They get to the mountain. Isaac carries his own wood. Jesus carried his own wood at the cross. There's a lot more than these that I'm just running through. All the Old Testament is types and shadows about our Mashiach, our Messiah. So they're going up the hill, and then Isaac says, "Hey, Dad, where's the sacrifice? Where's the animal we're going to sacrifice, you know?" And then Abraham says, "God himself shall provide a sacrifice." So see, God provided what? Himself as a sacrifice. So it's a double meaning. Not only did he provide a sacrifice, he provided himself as a sacrifice. So Abraham was prophesying that God himself would come on earth and die on the cross. Now, why am I, you know, and I'm talking about this specifically because the Lord, I just want to say this, as the Lord is in me, you know, like I say, there's lots of things I don't tell in videos, but just tonight, you know, the last week or two, the Lord keeps giving me Aramaic. When I'm praying in the Spirit, as it says in Jude, "Build up your most holy faith praying in the Spirit." Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 14 that praying in the Spirit is praying in tongues, not for public interpretation. That's the gift of tongues. But when you're baptized in the Holy Spirit, with the initial evidence of speaking in tongues like it is throughout the book of Acts, this is what we call praying in the Spirit. Praying in tongues, and it's not in the church. You're in private, and you're building up your most holy faith. Praying in the Spirit, as Paul said in 1 Corinthians 14, that our spirit prayeth. You know, and we, you know, we ask, and then we pray that we might interpret what we're saying, but we don't necessarily need to. It's a mystery, so we're praying between our spirit and God by the power of the Holy Spirit. Totally different thing. And anyhow, so I've been getting all this Aramaic, you know, because I know a few words in Aramaic, and I know it when I hear it, you know. Like in the movie The Passion of the Christ, you know, they're speaking Aramaic in there, a dead language. And I asked the Lord why, you know, the Lord even told me, you know, "Hey, this is Aramaic." But I knew it already, and then I said, "Well, Lord, why?" And the Lord said, "Because I'm the Son of Man." You know, so that's the thing about God. That's one of the little nugget out here as I'm flowing here in the Spirit of God. When you read, in other words, it's just like this. I mean, this is just so simple, yet people don't understand it. When you go to church and the pastor is led by the Lord, or you hear a teaching, like this video I'm doing, and someone is led by the Spirit of God, and then you get up there and teach on healing, you know, Jehovah, you know, Arafi, God is my healer, and you're teaching about the Lord healing people and all this, the anointing for healing is there. People come to the altar, they get prayed for to be healed. You know, and it should be. The anointing should be there for healing. It's not, the anointing is not there, you know, with a focus on deliverance from demons, because the message, if it was from the Lord, is about healing. Now, if the message is a message from the Lord about casting out demons, you would expect that you don't call people down to the altar to be prayed for to be healed, even though that can happen, but the focus would be on praying for people to be delivered from demons. You see what I'm saying? If you're flowing in the Spirit, that's what God wants to do. So, in other words, all these people that keep talking about the names of God in the Old Testament, all of the names of God we have are actually attributes of who God is. So when God revealed himself, like to Abraham, Abraham is the one that called him El Shaddai, God Almighty. That's the one of the ways that God revealed himself to the man Abraham, Father Abraham, as we should call him. He's the father of all who are of faith, you know, who come to God by faith. Abraham is the father of faith. That's why people call him, you know, Father Abraham, because that's what God told us in the Word of God, that he is our Father Abraham. You know, he's the father of all who are of faith. Romans chapter 4. Anyway, so, 3 and 4. Anyhow, brothers and sisters, so, when God reveals himself to us in a certain way, it's he's moving in that way. So, as an example, I've said this before, if you want to study eschatology, that's the study of the end times, when the Lord Jesus refers to himself, or he is referred to as the Son of Man, it's referring to when he's standing on the earth. When he's referred to as the Son of God, it's when he's not standing on the earth, when he's in heaven. So that's one clue, and I mentioned that before, but the Lord's just reminding me of that. When you're looking at the Lord as the Son of Man, you're talking about when he's on earth, dealing with his dealings here in this on earth. So right now, since the time of the resurrection, and you know, after the Lord ascended into heaven in Acts chapter 1, after the 40 days, Jesus has been seated at the right hand of the Father since that time. And the Holy Spirit of God has been moving on the earth. And the Lord has met with individuals, people that died near death and came back. They met with the Lord. The Lord has appeared to people. Okay. But the Lord himself is seated. And God can, the Lord can be anywhere, anytime. But when we're dealing with the presence of the Lord, it's really the Holy Spirit. And then the Lord manifests himself to us. As he said in John, I manifest myself to you through the Holy Spirit. But Jesus is seated at the right hand of the Father as our high priest, ever making intercession for us. Now, when he returns at the end of the tribulation, he will return as the King of kings and Lord of lords to rule and reign on earth. Right now, he's the high priest of the church. Okay, but he's going to stand up and he's going to get us the rapture, and that's going to be the end of the church age, and his role as that high priest intercessor of the church will be over with. At that time, he's going to be dealing, he'll be the bridegroom dealing with the bride for that 7 years. Then he returns. Okay, so this, you know, I'm just laying this stuff out, the right theology here, and what the Bible's teaching us, and what the Word of God says. So anyway, when the Lord is speaking to me tonight while I was praying, and it, you know, he is the Son of Man, it's like he's referring to when he's going to come get us. You know, he's coming back down to the earth. When he leaves heaven and comes back down here, even though we're meeting him in the air, it's a reference to he's the Son of Man, you know, because he's coming. As, you know, when we see him in heaven, just as an example, when Jesus walked the earth, here he is. But then when John went there, you know, in Revelation chapter 1, he saw Jesus as the high priest. He was dressed as a high priest. You know, that was God is revealing himself. You know, here he is as the high priest. So the description of Jesus in Revelation chapter 1. But then when he returns to earth at the end of the tribulation, brothers and sisters, he's dressed in a different outfit. He's dressed in a vesture dipped in blood, and he's got written on his thigh and all this, you know, King of kings and Lord of lords. See, so it's a different clothes that he's wearing. But why is he doing that? You know, it's like, well, I believe, and Jesus is wearing a robe dipped of, you know, vestures dipped in blood. Well, it's, you know, when God has given us these names like Jehovah Jireh and Jehovah Nissi and El Shaddai and El Elyon, the Most High God, El Shaddai, God Almighty, all these things, it's a revelation of who God is. You know, I am that I am, you know, in English, but it's really this Asher. I keep forgetting how it says the I am that I am. It's something that you, most of you never even heard before. And it's something Asher, you know, anyway, it doesn't matter. You know, you don't have to speak Hebrew to go to heaven. It's I am that I am, and what he's saying in English. And so anyway, when these things that we see about the Lord in Revelation, this is a revelation. It's just, you know, we can see him, and God is trying to convey, you know, a lot of metaphoric things to us too, you know, about who Jesus is, clothes dipped in blood, vestures in blood, because, you know, of all the wicked people and all those things it describes in the Old Testament, you know, the destruction of all the wickedness, all these different things, even though it's literally going to be like that, but it's also, it's a revelation about God. You know what I'm saying? God is trying to put it, you know, like parables. It's like parables. He's putting it in terms we can understand, because we can never, that's the thing about all these people, it's, you know, all this people that's doing, it's all about God up here and not in the spirit. That's the thing about it. You know, the people that you deal with, there's lots of people that are mentally understanding, but it's not in here, you know, so they're like using this, but it's, they're not getting it in the spirit. And so the bottom line is what I'm trying to say with those that the Lord wants me to share with you guys is that, you know, we can, God by definition is beyond understanding. So all these people, especially when you're dealing with atheists and even a lot of Christians, all these analytical minded high theologians that I deal with and that you might come across, they are trying to, you know, just like the Bible answer man. The guy doesn't even, you know, he believes that there's not even, you know, he's an amillennialist. He doesn't even believe there's going to be a tribulation and all that. He is at Hank Hinegraaff. He's totally whacked and totally mentally, you know, closed-minded and has zero spirituality about him at all. You know, the opposite of a true Christian in that way. I don't know, but I believe that he loves the Lord and all that, but he's just totally closed-minded. Just use him as a great example. You know, he's not grasping the fact that, you know, like trying to, you know, all those people throughout the ages of the church, if you look at church history, they're killing each other over this doctrine of the Trinity as an example. I mean, if God is God, you can never understand only what he chooses to reveal himself to us as. As Jesus said, no one can see the Father save the Son, and nobody can see the Son save he reveal him. You know, so the Lord Jesus is the one who can reveal the Father to us, you know, members of the church, us Gentiles, you know, the church. Because, you know, God revealed himself to Israel as a nation and individuals like Abraham and Noah and all that, and you know what I'm saying. Anyhow, so these are only just revelations of just like, you know, I don't even say it's 1%. You know, just get a little flash of infinity And then, woo, I know all about God. I'm an expert on God. You know, God is love. Like the Bible says, God is love. That's one thing about God. One attribute of God is love. Okay, love is defined. The standard for love is defined by God. You know, the immutable, unmoving, unchanging God. Okay. But that's not all there is to know about God. That's just one little drop in the ocean, man. So that's a good metaphor, I guess. You know, saying you know God is like saying, hey, I got a drop of the ocean. Here, I'm holding the Pacific Ocean in my hand. You got a drop in your hand. Come on. I mean, you know, and when people would humble themselves, all these high theologians and all this debating on YouTube and the internet and in the world, if you just get the fact that you holding a drop of water in your hand talking about how you know all about God, you've grasped all of the Pacific Ocean with a drop of water from the Pacific Ocean in your hand. Come on, man. Come on. It might be the only reason why you knew it was from the Pacific is because somebody told you. I mean, it could actually be from the Atlantic. You know what I'm saying? You only know because if I came and gave you drop water and said, oh, this is from the Pacific Ocean, hey, I could have got it out of the toilet, man. You don't know. You know, you're only going by what I chose to reveal to you, see? So we only know what God chose to reveal to us. And even what he's revealed to the church, like the Bible, you know, it's spiritually discerned. So you can't even understand the Bible if God doesn't let you have the discernment to know it. Much less any kind of a new thing that you think that God told you. That's why, brothers and sisters, you can't get up and caught up with all this bizarre stuff that people are talking. You know, this whatever. Thank God it's almost over with. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm just going on and on. I'm just excited. I'm excited. You know, like I said, and I just want to say this. I just want to say it again. Maybe nothing is going to happen. I just want to say this. Maybe nothing is going to happen in September at all, brothers and sisters. Even though it seems like very, very likely that all this stuff's coming together. And, you know, we've discussed all that. And, you know, as I said, I've said this before, I'll say it again. I think it's going to be something big. It could be the War of Gog and Magog is what happens with this September. And then the rapture is going to be on months out. You know, that will result in the rise of the Antichrist, which will result in the rapture just before that. It could be 6 months from now or a year from now. I don't know that. I just want to say that. Even though in my spirit, I feel like the Lord is telling me, it's sooner than we think. And all the dreams and stuff I have. But sometimes dreams are dreams, brothers and sisters. Like in my dream, I saw the August the 18th date, but I didn't see 2015 as an example. Even though, you know, I don't know the Lord would give me that date. It's so soon, and then let me say it, and then it's 5 years from now or something, you know. I'm just putting that out there. Anyway, brothers and sisters, let's be excited. But, you know, let's realize that, hey, you know, we're all infallible, myself included. And the Lord is going to do it when he wants to. We need to be ready at any time. That's always the same message from the Lord. Be ready because the Son of Man. See, thank you, Lord. See, the Lord gave me the Bible reference while he's talking about the Son of Man. I didn't even, you know, I didn't have a Bible verse reference for that, reference to the rapture, and now the Lord just gave it to me. See how God is so awesome. See, if you watch this video till now, then you're getting some. See, God establishes everything by the, you know, the witnesses of his word. He said, because the Son of Man comes at the hour that you least expect. See, when he's talking about coming back to the church, he calls himself the Son of Man. Ha ha. See, I didn't even think about that. I didn't even know it. Just rambling on here as the Lord is leading me, and then there you go. There's a reference. Praise God, brothers and sisters. So I'm saying, man, God is faithful. God probably had me put that in there because there was somebody. Well, the Bible doesn't say. I was just talking about. See? God answers. You know, if you humble yourself. I mean, like I say, I'm definitely not perfect, brothers and sisters. But I would say that what I do, that's an example to you, my brothers and sisters. You got to stay humble. You got to always be humble, man. This when you think you know things, then you find out you don't. I mean, how many times I thought, yeah, I got it down pat, man. Yeah, I know what God's talking about. Then God throws me one of them curveballs, you know. You know, then I'm like, wait a minute. You know, it just changed the whole paradigm I was looking at. It's been opened up now. It's a whole new thing I didn't even think about. That's even better than what I was thinking before. You know, that's how God is, man. God is awesome, brothers and sisters. He gives grace to the humble, but he resists the proud. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm going to put this out. And it's already long, so that's good then. That means that only people that are really wanting to, you know, hear the and flow in the prophetic discipleship stuff that the Lord's had me doing will be watching. So praise God for that. Praise God for the brothers and sisters in Christ. I love all you guys. I just can't thank you guys enough. I just want to say that again. I really appreciate all you guys that have been praying for me. Because when I first went to the Philippines on my own, using my own savings and all that, until, you know, started Joshua's ministry, 2012. I went there full time in 2007, and I went 2005 and 2006 for like 3 months each year before I moved there. I didn't have anybody really praying for me, and that was a big, you know, that was a mistake. It made it, I was able to get stuff done, but 100 times harder. And since I started a YouTube ministry, like I said, the Lord let me start it for the end times teaching. I never even thought about Joshua's ministry, of course. That didn't happen until over a year later. And I never even thought about the fact that, hey, these people's going to be praying for me, my brothers and sisters in Christ. And people would donate to build the orphanages and all that. And so the prayers of you guys, it's been a game changer for Joshua's ministry, you know, and which wouldn't start after YouTube. But anyway, for the ministry that God gave me to do, whatever we're going to call it, that I've had. My ministry used to be called Walking by Faith. That's the name that the Lord gave me, and that's what I started with in 2001, was Walking by Faith Ministries. And I was, you know, doing evangelism, healing evangelism, you know. And I got ordained. I got licensed, though, at earlier than that. But I got ordained on Mother's Day 2001. Can't forget that. I think that's May the 14th, 2001. So, you know, praise God. And that's the name of my ministry, was Walking by Faith Evangelistic Ministries. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I keep forgetting. I need to get some business cards made. And some people, if you, there's a company you can get it done cheap. And I heard the advertisement on the radio one time. I know that some of you guys know it's really cheap. I think it's like $15 for 100 or 500 cards. I want to put one in each book. I keep forgetting to do that with, you know, my email and stuff, so people can email me. Anyway, brothers and sisters, if I know somebody will put the link down there for me to the name of the place. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you all.